and most of us don't even realize that spending that extra time scrolling our news feed, you just need to develop a day-to-day cash flow statement, sitting for the longer time is as dangerous as smoking. You know, later it will foster your independence but as well help you to save the money. So, all of us are in a lockdown. By this time, you would have completed with your Netflix list, storybook list, surfing through Facebook, Instagram, and yeah, lastly, tired of sleeping. Don't fret, guys. There are still plenty of productive things left to do at home. Hey, guys. This is Mr. Money, and today I'm not here with a usual travel vlog. Instead, I'm here to get yourself busy with the 10 awesome, productive, and the fun activities to do at home, which would help you to grow. The best way to learn something is to simply do it, but with a receptive as well as a participative attitude. Learning a life-saving skill about how to do a first aid, the most important activity, which includes the study about handling a victim in a common scenario such as bleeding or poisoning, burns, or even a respiratory emergency. So, the condition never changes. So if you're already done with it, no problem. Try giving it a revision. Update your knowledge, or you may help your kids learn it. Beside that, try learning some basic working principle of the home tools such as hammer, screwdriver, wrench, even needles and knife. Learning about some basic home repairs, later it will foster your independence but as well help you to save the money. You may even involve your kids in this task. Try becoming a multilingual. Yes, the more number of languages you speak, the more flexible as well as the more clearer your communication becomes. Start learning with the standard languages obviously English. So what you can do is try implementing the new words to your vocabulary and try using them in your real life. International languages such as Spanish is the easiest to learn if you are a native English speaker. Learning of the other languages such as French would add more weightage to your CV. Guys, don't let your present state get you down, whatever your past may be. That is to set a goal. Build a strong mindset. Be as predictive and as imaginative as you can. Build your own standards and try sticking to them. All you need is to plan your steps. Just keep working until you celebrate. Even if your goal is to get a job or which are related to some any of the job performance or a career change, or you are deciding or planning to win a tournament, maybe you are getting involved in leaner or muscular, Just be preparative and plan your steps, work hard until you celebrate. Guys, all you have to do is to take it as a passion or a hobby. Soon you will realize there's no other boredom surrounding you. I feel like making a plan is usually thought to be a good thing, but yeah, having a backup plan is always something which makes you confident at times. For the ease, for security, for flexibility, about anything which you are emotionally attached or is important for you, you may go for a backup. Try backing up your childhood photos, or even photos with some vacations, or the photos with the friends in a concert. With the presence of kids, elderly people, backing up medicines at home becomes a smarter step. Besides to that, the computer data, phone data, PDFs, class notes, e-books are some other common things that you should back up according to your interest. Amidst the current scenario, planning out your future is a crucial step in mapping out our financial year. All you have to do is just start with setting up a goal. Secondly, see where your money goes. You just need to develop a day-to-day cash flow statement. Prepare your plans for emergency. Create your expense budget. You may plan for your retirement. It is because you have good financial plan, it is always easier to make financial decisions and stay on track even when you meet such an economic crisis. Talking about the merits of the social media, it's always been a game of numbers, starting from the personal profile followers, your likes, dislikes, comments, and even if you're into some branding advertisement as well. The proper indulgence into the social media with some good strategies would help you grow in any of the field nowadays. Since in this state you are at home, plan to reach some larger audience, write some blogs, You may create some own viral videos, your own organic content, uncover some valuable knowledge. Another point is that you get creative, shoot some of your photos in your house itself. And the best productive point about the internet is you may go try join some Facebook group, gain the knowledge about the politics, you know, the maybe some environment, world health, or anything which is related to some current affairs. And yeah, you just need to keep yourself updated. In this state, you have been stuck into the house. This will make you more anxious and thereby make you more stressed. The best way to free you from the unwanted as well as the unwelcome thoughts is to engaging yourself in some interesting activities. You may try making craft of paper or plastic. You can go for paper models as well. You may try decorating for your home. You may change the positioning of your home furniture. For the girls, they can get creative with some curtains or make some wall hangings. Get creative with some photo frames. You know, the changlers will help. Drawing, painting, coloring would also help you to kill the anxiety. But I would recommend you to get your kids busy in that activity so that you can help yourself too with some other productive days. Rather than reading a book, yeah, write a one. Yes, you might not be an expert in this, but as a beginner, you may make your story characters from your past, maybe your friends or former family, or yeah, you may even involve them in this writing. Luckily, if you are from an extended family, try playing some indoor games like scavengers hunt, I Spy, musical chairs, common one, Uno, etc. And you may Google these rules. I think I don't need not to post these rules in my description. I would like to say that the real world is far better than the virtual one. You know, a scientific fact, sitting for the longer time is as dangerous as smoking. And most of us don't even realize the spending that extra time scrolling our newsfeed. Yeah guys, I want you to take a break from this endless scrolling, not permanently. Try giving it as a temporary basis. And you know guys, you just need to imagine the state that when you don't need to worry about any of your phone calls, your mobile phones buzzing left and right, you know, the messages, the video calls. And yeah, at that same moment, you will get more work done and even faster. Yeah, giving up the social media, giving up your online life would help you to rebuild your offline life. Yeah, I mean about the communication. Giving up social media would bring you to the non-comparable, non-judgmental and positive, peaceful world. People around the world are facing problems with managing relationship with their family or with the partners within close confines for weeks and the months at the end. Unlike the usual times, either the parents are out for the work or the kids are out for the schools and the colleges, and they hardly share a family time except for that on the weekends. Fortunately, this is the time to improve the quality as well as the quantity of the communication between your family members and the partners. As home becomes the new office nowadays, it's incredibly important to schedule your time for the family, and even your family should seem to be looking forward to these moments. Be it reading a book for your teenager kids or active communication with your daughter. Communication can be anything. Guys, this is the time to bridge the communication gap between your family. See movies together, try eating meals together, engage into a small talks. You just need to be an active listener always. You may interview your grandparents. You may ask them about their childhood times, about the facilities provided during their times, about anything randomly under the sky. If you're a tech lover or you belong from a tech family, you can go and create a website where your son would share some of his random pictures, or your daughter could write some poems up. Jumping to my favorite point, it's not always about looking better, it's always to feel better. The trick is not to spend the fortune over the thousands of products or to be locked for hours in a bathroom. Rather, it's about developing a daily routine which is quick as well as effective. Start off with taking care of your skin, your hairs, your nails, just with the products that suits you the best and the basic equipments in your home. Boys, since you are at home, experimenting on your looks won't be a bad option. You may try with different hairstyles. You may grow, shave, or even trim your beards in order to get a change. Even girls, on the other hand, should try doing their nails after a manicure or a pedicure. You can even pamper yourself with a good facial or try different combinations of the clothes by mixing and matching your wardrobe. Coming to the very mandatory as well as the topmost point which you need to include is leading a healthy lifestyle. Guys, good health is not something that you buy like other materialistic things. As quoted by Mahatma Gandhi, it's the health that is the real wealth, but not the pieces of gold and silver. So guys, as you are at home, it's the best time to correct your sleep habit, food habit, and indulge some good exercise and keep your lifestyle healthy. The first and even the most important step of leading a healthy lifestyle is going early to bed and getting at least a sleep of 8 hours in order to make your tissue cells work according to the biological rhythm. With the growing demand of the families, you know, responsibilities, demanding jobs, exercise can take a back seat in your inner priority list. This couldn't be done. Most of us give brilliant excuses for not exercising on daily basis, but that's bad. To begin with exercises, you don't really need to hit the gym. Everything you need is a mind setup and a beautiful home. To begin, you don't need to really pick up heavy weights. You can start with the freehand exercises such as push-ups, pull-ups, especially for the boys, crunches, lunges, even the planks for girls as well. And even 30 minutes of cardio would give countless benefits on the long-term basis. You know, it's always easy to get confused when it comes to health and nutrition. Start tracking your food intake now and then. Keep a diary count, written count. Don't go for a dieting. Stay hydrated, obviously, and get a track of everything. And you don't need to fear coffee. Okay guys, these were the 10 productive things that you could try doing at home during this quarantine and fight this virus. Stay home, stay safe, and get productive. Guys, don't forget to share the activities that you like in this video. If you want me to come up with such related content, do let me know in the comments box. If this video was helpful, give it a like. Share this video as much as you can. And yeah, lastly, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Okay guys, this was Mr. Manni signing out from this YouTube video. And we will meet with some another content the very next time. Thank you.